see little blue lights on?
I do.
Okay, sweet.
Good morning and welcome to our last Old School Chapel of the year for the 2020-2021 school year. We're so glad that you're able to join us online, even though we cannot be together this morning. We will start with a worship song, so I will give it over to Mr. Leung now.
Thank you, Ms. Myberg. Let's all come together and sing a song of praise, and then we'll pray.
It's so sweet to trust in Jesus and to take Him at His word, just to rest upon His promise and to know, thus saith the Lord. Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus, just to trust His cleansing blood, and in simple faith to plunge in the healing cleansing flood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Yes, 'tis sweet to trust in Jesus, just from sin and self to cease, just from Jesus simply taking life and rest and joy and peace. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. I'm so glad that I learned to trust Him, precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that Thou art with me, will be with me to the end. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Let's close this time of worship with a word of prayer. Father, we trust You because You are good and You are in control, God. Lord, we thank You so much for a year of schooling and being together, God. But even though it's been challenging here at the end, we trust that You are good and You love us, God. And so, Lord, we pray that You would encourage us with Your Holy Spirit and that Your truth would reign in our hearts and we would take joy and hope and peace in You. In Jesus' name, amen.
It's hard to believe that this is the last theme wrap-up that I will be doing with you as a school. Let's see if many of you can remember our theme verse. So if you're at home, why don't you join me by saying our theme verse for one last time this school year? 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. This year, we focused a lot on being new. In your chapels and your classes, you talked about what that looks like. Your actions, your words, your thoughts, all those things should look different when you're a new creation. They should look more like what Jesus would do. It's not easy to make those changes, though. Sometimes we just want to do what we feel. Maybe your classmate or your little brother or sister is giving you a really hard time and they're bothering you, and maybe you lose your temper and you kind of want to get back at them and just lash out. Or maybe somebody hurts you on the playground or somewhere else and you feel like you want to take revenge. But this verse reminds us that when we're a new creation, we need to make different choices. A new creation needs to stop and think about everything that they do, say, and think. We should not just respond how we feel. We should behave differently than the world. A new creation thinks differently. A new creation acts differently. A new creation talks differently. As you look back on this past school year, I hope that you've been able to see areas where God has made you new, and maybe some other areas where you can continue to become new in the future. So I hope that as we spend this time together this morning, you can reflect on the year behind you and see how you have grown. And now it's time for a new theme. And now I'm going to give it over to your new principal for next year, Mr. Zach Sawyer, and he's going to share what the theme will be for the 2021-2022 school year. Mr. Sawyer.
Thanks, Ms. Myberg. Hi, everybody at home. We sure wish we were all together and we could see you guys, but excited for what's coming next year. And yeah, as Ms. Myberg said, we are going to have a new theme. And some of you might remember, we always have a theme art contest for students to participate in and draw their own art and design for the theme. This art contest will be over the summer, and all of the art pieces that you produce, you can turn those in the first couple weeks of school. This even has cash prizes for elementary and secondary students. So if you want to participate, I would highly recommend you spend some time on it this summer thinking about our new theme, and you can win anywhere from 500 to 1,000 NT for first, second, and third prize in elementary and secondary. So I'd like to introduce our new theme for next year, which is refresh. And let's read the passage here from John 4, verses 13 and 14. It says, Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life." So this passage is about a woman who meets Jesus and experiences a radical life change. From this encounter with Jesus, the woman's thinking is refreshed. Her understanding of God is refreshed, and her spirit is refreshed. You see, Jesus came to this woman not because the water she was drinking was bad, but because he wanted to offer her a deeper refreshment that would quench the thirst in her soul. Jesus came to offer himself, the spring of water welling up to eternal life. I personally love this passage because it reminds me of how my own heart, soul, and mind were refreshed when I first met Jesus. I too experienced a radical life change. And as I prayed and asked Jesus to forgive my sins and to fill my life, I was 18 years old, and for the first time in my life, I had an eternal hope and a purpose worth living for. This passage also reminds me that Jesus is the place that I need to look for the grace, peace, joy, and forgiveness that I need every single day. I need this important reminder that my true refreshment is found in Jesus and nowhere else. You see, I love life. I love enjoying my life. And there's so many good things in this world that seem like they should be refreshing to my heart, mind, and soul. I love biking. I love surfing. I love adventuring. If you've been my student, you've heard stories about, you know, oh, Mr. Sawyer went surfing again this weekend, or, you know. Pretty much, that's what I love to do. I love my family. I love my friends. I love my community at MAT. These are all really, really good things that I enjoy and I find satisfaction in. And I'm sure that you, students and parents, also have a lot of really good things that you can find satisfaction in. But my soul, and I believe all of our souls, long for more. We long for eternity. We long for purpose. We long for hope and joy and peace. And in our world today, we face many unknown and uncertain realities. COVID-19 has threatened us here in Taiwan for the last 18 months or so. And of course, as you guys know, especially over the last 2 weeks. As of today, we're uncertain how it's going to end. When will it end? We're tired. We're weary. We're waiting for some good news. And we need something to put our hope in. The awesome part about this passage is that Jesus came to earth for people just like us in situations just like ours, where we are afraid, we're struggling to understand the world. Today, Jesus is speaking to us and inviting us to be refreshed in him. There's no other person, there's no other place, there's no other thing, that can truly refresh us. When we meet Jesus and we seek him each day, he forgives our sins. He offers us hope. He gives us new life. Jesus is the only one who can truly refresh us. So I have to say, I'm excited as I look forward to next year and what lies ahead. I'm excited to join together as a community seeking Jesus to refresh our hearts, our minds, to refresh our hopes and our dreams, to refresh our thinking and our relationships. As we look ahead to next school year, let's pray and ask Jesus to be our strength, to be our hope, and to refresh us. Amen. I'm looking forward to seeing you guys in August. Have a great summer.
Thank you, Mr. Sawyer. I think that's just the perfect message that we need at a time like this. And I'm really looking forward to hearing more as Mr. Sawyer takes over for me next year. Next, we're going to start by celebrating our students. And we are going to start first with the music award. So I'm going to have Mr. Garcia, Ms. Will, and Mrs. Wan come out to share their awards.
This year's the Brian Schwab Middle School Band Award is given to a student who displays servant leadership and just a love for band and encouragement to others. This year there are two award recipients. They are Nathan Yates and Maya Lee. The High School Choir Award is given to a student who maybe doesn't always sing like all the time, all correctly, but they really try their best and they encourage others and they sing for the Lord, and that's really important. This year, there are two recipients. That's Malachi Sawyer and Katie Cottle. And lastly, the High School Band Award is going to be given to two students who show servant leadership and dedication to band, and their ensemble, and really trying their best every rehearsal, despite whatever challenges may come their way. The two recipients are Daniel Hahn and Jonathan Pong.
I would like to begin by acknowledging two seniors that were missed in this morning's high school awards ceremony. The High School Performing Arts Award is given in recognition of 4 years of participation in music or drama. The two high school senior recipients are Isaac Tu and Danny Su. The Middle School Orchestra Award goes to three students that have shown excellence in their playing, dedication, and musicianship. They have maintained a high level of playing throughout the year. Congratulations to Rachel Song, Abigail Wu, and Sophia Chu. The High School Orchestra Awards go to two students that have demonstrated excellent playing, playing that showed their musicality in class and in their test recordings. And most importantly, playing that lead the ensemble and kept the ensemble together. This award goes to Danny Su and Sandy Yip.
This year's Middle School Choir Awards go to two students who have not only learned our songs well, but have positively supported me in all of my decisions and strove for excellence in their singing. I would like to present them to Abigail Kim and Kiana Sawyer.
Congratulations to all the students that received those awards. The certificates will be placed inside your yearbooks that will be sent home in the bags tomorrow and Friday. We will now move on to our Timothy Award winners. This is a very important award that we give out at the end of every year. The choice is made on the basis of a student who demonstrates positive attitude, consistent obedience, service to others, and good interpersonal relationship skills. Each teacher from each grade will come and announce the winners for that grade level. So now the homeroom teachers will come up one at a time. We will start with kindergarten.
These two students are very thoughtful and kind and gentle all the time to their classmates. And the winners for this year go to Abigail Hsu and Elijah Palma.
The first grade recipients are Iana Ye and Landon Klump.
For second grade, the Timothy Awards go to Yo-Yo Chen and Aaron Dom. Good job.
Our third grade winners of the Timothy Awards are Livia Cho and Ben Cottle.
The fourth grade recipients are Sophia Song and Cairo Sai.
And for fifth grade, we have Kyan Chang and Dietrich Chilton.
The sixth grade recipients are Austin Tai and Allison Nee.
For seventh grade, we have Kiana Sawyer and Hudson Cottle.
This year's eighth grade winners of the Timothy Award are Ava Wang and Wesley Huang.
For ninth grade, Rachel Xie and Stefan Young.
Tenth grade's Timothy Award winners are Kimberly Hsu and Malachi Sawyer.
For 11th grade, we have Daniel Han and Katrina Im.
For 12th grade, we have Florence Huang and Isaac Tu.
And now we will do the awards for the Abiding Broncos. And we have a special guest who will be announcing those this year. Ms. Elisa Klum.
Today I've been asked to give the Abiding Bronco Award. This award is given to students who have attended their entire school years at Morrison Academy. For the first time, we are able to give this award to students who began with us in kindergarten and have remained at Morrison all the way through grade 12. What an honor it is to be able to give this award today, as these students started in my kindergarten class 13 years ago. So today, the Abiding Bronco Award goes to Stephen Chang, Will Chen, John Lee, Ashish Perswani, and Raphael Xu.
Congratulations to all our award winners. We will now transition and celebrate our seniors with the senior video.
Thank you.
Yo, seniors, the seventh grade culture trip pictures straight up gave me PTSD. I'm just playing. We miss you greatly and really hope that you could be with us today at this time. But we know that even though we're far apart, we still hope you know that we still love you and we still miss you. And we still pray for you and wish you the best. At this time, I would like to pray for our departing seniors, but not only just the seniors, also the students and staff who've been with us in our community who will also be leaving. I'm so grateful that because of the promises in God's word, we know that even though we are apart, we are never permanently apart. For those of us in Christ, we're always going to be together. We're always going to be brothers and sisters, and we will see each other again one day in eternity with our Lord Jesus, and it's going to be super awesome. And so today we say goodbye temporarily to the wonderful members of our community. You will be missed and thought about often, but it is only temporary, and we will see you all soon. So let's please join me as we pray for the students and staff that you see on your screen right now, and also for the seniors from the video that we just watched. Let's pray together. Gracious Father, we thank you for your love and for your grace. We thank you for that promise that you've made, that while we may be far apart physically, or we may be going to different countries or different schools, God, that we are united by one spirit. We thank you that in your Son, there are no cultural or no physical divides, that we are all united in the most important thing, and that's your Son, Jesus. Lord, we pray that as our friends and our brothers and sisters leave and depart from our community today, that you would continue to guide them and sanctify them and be with them and give them peace and joy when they need it. Give them truth and encouragement when they need it, God. And Lord, we pray that you would continue to raise up people in their lives around them to bless them and support them and to be there for them as every community needs, as every individual needs, God. And so, Lord, we pray that you would help us to continue to pray for them and support them, and that they wouldn't be afraid to come visit and say hi. And so, Lord, we pray that you would bless these individuals, these teachers and staff members, these students, these seniors, God, as they step into the next chapter of their lives, God, we pray that you would be glorified and they would be edified and encouraged in you. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for everything, and in your name we pray. Amen. And so at this time, we also want to give a special shout out and thank you to the yearbook team for working so hard to create our beautiful yearbooks, which you will get shortly. The cover is matte and soft, and it's really great. You'll see it soon. But they've also prepared a really great video for us. And so thank you, yearbook team, so much. And I hope you guys enjoy this video.
Are wearing thick, yeah. Burning that candle till it's burned out. No sign of a second wind. There's a voice in my ear, soft but so clear, saying I'm still right here. So don't you dare go giving up. Fight the good fight, even when the fight ain't fair. Keep your hopes high. Taste
fighting the good fight.
Wow, what a bunch of wonderful memories to reflect on. I really wish all of you were in the NPR with me here today. When people have ever asked me in the past if I have any kids, I would always tell them, yes, I have 296 of them, because that's how much I love each one of you. Being your principal for the past 6 years has been such a blessing and honor. You're truly an amazing group of students, teachers, and parents. Thank you for all your love and support over the years. I will miss you all so much. I wish that I could be here saying this to you in person. Dear students, in the front of your yearbook, I have placed a letter for you since I cannot say goodbye to you in person. On there, you will find my personal email address, and I hope you will keep in touch with me in the future. Whether I knew you from coaching on a team, being your advisor, greeting you in the hallways, supervising you at lunch or on the playground, watching you perform on the stage, or even if you came to visit me, each one of you is so very special to me, and I am so proud of each and every one of you. I will miss you very, very much. I'm so thankful that we will always remain family in Christ, no matter where we are located in the world. I would like to say a special prayer for you now. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for this wonderful school community. Lord, I thank you for every student and teacher and parent that's part of MIT. I pray for your special hand of blessing on them, whether they're staying here or going somewhere else for this next chapter. Thank you for the blessing that they've been to my lives in my life, and I just pray that you bless them as they move on. Lord, thank you for your faithfulness and your goodness, and thank you for all the ways that you provided for our school over the past 6 years. I lift them all up to you now in Jesus' name. Amen. So it's that time of the year again where we get to do our countdown. Even though we cannot be together, we are going to do it from wherever we are located. So you can either join us on the Google Meet link that your homeroom teacher sent you, or you can just count down with us together now on the screen. Are you ready for this? Let's go. 10, 9,